The laws of nature and the will of the creator.
First of all, there is a difference between a law of nature and a private leadership that teaches. Private leadership that teaches. So, for example, when a person smells smoke, then he coughs. What does this leadership teach? It teaches that it is not right to breathe smoke. That it is equivalent to saying that it is not right to put corruption in the body. This is a very private leadership, a cough. Even when trying to smell hot pepper, there is a cough. Because if you do not pick hot pepper, it stays attached to the tree. As saying, it is not right to pick me, so I stay attached to the tree. Unlike other fruits that fall from the tree, and say we are destined to detach from the tree. Therefore, picking hot pepper is considered to be corrupting. And again, it is not right to smell the odor of corruption, according to this leadership of the cough we have seen, because in doing so the odor of corruption is introduced into the body. So cough is private leadership. Another example of private leadership that expresses the same principle is that if chemicals are injected into the body by injection or in pills, then it has negative side effects. Once again, because it involves the insertion of corruption into a body, and by law it is not right to put corruption into a body. So there are negative side effects, to say that it is not right to do so. The same is true in a global view. The world itself is also a body, an inanimate body, a large body that contains us all. So it is not right to bring corruption into the world as well, and therefore it is not right to burn things in the world. And we can see that fires cause hot gas emissions. And these cause heat waves and dry climates, once again, a form of expression of the same law that says corruption must not be introduced into any body. So if we look at such broad evidence, then we can come to a law and say, it is wrong to introduce corruption into any body. This is already a formulation, called a formulation of a law. Because it applies to all levels of life. Inanimate, vegetative, and living. And we have seen here one trend, which is manifested in several different ways. Let's take an example of another law. According to the leadership, it was determined that if no fruit is picked, then it falls off the tree alone. This is an example of private leadership, right? The fruit is not picked, so it reaches a state where it falls off on its own, and it falls off in a shade of ripe fruit. What does this leadership come to say? Fruit is meant to be picked. Unlike leaves and stems that are not meant to be plucked, right? As long as the leaf is moist, then it stays attached to the tree, and only when it dries does it fall off the tree. Like saying, as long as I have not dried, I should be attached to the tree. A fruit, on the other hand, falls in the shade of a ripe fruit, which means that even when the fruit is ripe, it is right to pick it, because it does not spoil and only then falls. On the other hand, there are sick trees that drop fruit only after they have rotted. So it can be confusing to learn from private leaderships because they are not inclusive. One tree behaves this way while another tree may behave differently. Legal leadership, however, is leadership that expresses a law that applies to all levels of life. A law that expresses the wisdom of life, so one can learn from that leadership without being confused. Because all levels of life abide by the law it expresses. In our case, how do we know from which leadership to learn? From the tree that drops rotten fruit? Or from the tree that drops fruit in the shade of ripe fruit? In order to know which leadership of them is a leadership that comes to teach the wisdom of life, one needs a very broad vision. A vision that allows us to examine which leadership complements together with the other leaderships for the wisdom of life. So as mentioned, there are leaderships like hunger that came to direct us to eat, and there are leaderships like the leadership that the fruit falls from the tree in a shade of ripe fruit. And these leaderships came to direct us to pick fruit. And suddenly there is a leadership that says the fruit is meant to stay attached to the tree because it falls off only after it breaks down. as it have someone who says as long as I have not broken down I should stay connected to the tree. It is clear that this leadership is breaking the continuum because what else is there to eat besides fruits? And besides, for what is there fruit in the world if not for eating? They are delicious and have a pleasant smell and the size of a dish, and they are accessible to eat, and if the peels are returned above their root, then the peel is obtained at the root to be a re-fruit. And so it turns out that even the fruit we ate from it is not perishable. And if so, the law of life is kept because we do not live at each other's expense. In short, immediately we see that a tree that bears fruit only after it has rotted is a diseased tree. So there are also trees that shed fruit while in a shade of ripe fruit. Therefore, we will learn from the trees that shed fruit in the shade of ripe fruit and not from those trees that drop rotten fruit. Indeed, if we wait until the fruit falls from the tree, we will not be able to eat all the fruit that will fall. So we must know that already when the fruit is ripe and ready to be picked easily, even then it is right to pick it. Of course, we are talking about deciduous fruit. So if we wanted to formulate this leadership that a fruit falls in a shade of ripe fruit, and we would like to formulate it legally, what should we say? We had to say that nature teaches what is right to be done, because what is right to be done will happen like it's in the world anyway. So an image that is right to be in the world will be anyway. The fruits should be picked, then they will fall anyway, and they will fall in a ripe fruit shade. That is to say, there is a leadership that teaches a purpose. The purpose of the fruit to detach from the tree, unlike leaves or branches or stems whose purpose is to stay connected.
In conclusion, we have seen that a number of different leaderships that point to the same trend can direct us to draft a law. And we have seen that there is a difference between a private leadership that teaches and a private leadership that does not teach the wisdom of life. And we have also seen that there is a difference between leadership and law, because law is in fact the formulation of a conclusion derived from private leaderships, and as a conclusion. The law of nature is a general conclusion that is true for all levels of life, the inanimate grows and lives. Thus, the law of nature surely represents the will of the Creator because there are several different levels of life that sustain it, and therefore a pattern can be obtained through it called an image. An image of leadership or an image of a form that is right to be in the world. And now it may be clear to you, why I learn the will of the Creator only through the laws of nature. Because they are conclusions derived from leaderships who together teach the wisdom of life. The end.
If you are interested in such content, feel free to subscribe to the channel and click the bell to get an update on each new video, and see you next time.